Hey everybody, it's Vic Dez. Time to continue our Eden streak here in the Binding of Isaac Vic to Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you everybody for continuing to root me on here as we go into the 102nd win, looking for 103. You can see today is going to be 06380 kilobytes a second. Terrible damage. Well, slightly worse than average damage. Acceptable movement speed, I suppose. But the problem that I'm seeing right off the bat is going to be the fact that we got good old-fashioned 16-tier delay. And that is not wait what. That is the actual Butterbean. So, I'd be lying if I said that this was a good start. Is this a pill-taking run? I think the answer is a resounding yes, because we really don't have a whole lot to lose at this point. Oh, it's Curse of the Blind too, apparently. Scapular, sure, Scapular's fine. It's a good defensive item. Not exactly what we wanted to start off with a defensive item here, especially when we're in such dire need for offense. Yeah, like this is like the worst type of room that we could have not hoped for, because we cannot fire fast enough around the Fat Isaac statues. And we're just gonna get inundated with these rooms here. All right. So, what do we need on this run? Everything. This is the quintessential type of run that Sinvicta hates. Low damage and low tears rate. That will kill you faster than anything else in this game. And we have a, like, that either one of those would kill you in any part of this game. We have a combination of the two. So, like, this doesn't get any, I mean, it gets bad, but, like, as you're seeing here in this room, yeah, this is awful. Lately, it seems like the game's really trying my patience. I'm not even, like, joking here. We may actually be in here until we die. Like, that is not an exaggeration. Our tears rate is so bad, we don't have the DPS to kill all of these things. Or maybe we do. We got one now, that's okay, good. Alright, well, never mind. Alright, it was a little bit of an exaggeration. But, man. Bring on the rerolls. We also have Mom's Eye, by the way, which gives us the occasional shot coming out of the back of our head. Yeah, see, like, these rooms here are not the best. Luckily, the Shy Guy did some favors for us. I think those are actually called, not hosts, but they're called hives or something like that. Got a penny for our troubles. Hooray. What is this? This room is, I'm very confused at what I'm seeing in this room right now. In fact, my brain cannot process it. So we're gonna jump into the lion's maw here. I know I'm taking this super slow, but that's because I don't trust this run. I don't trust anything that's going on in this run right now. So Scapular, instead of us taking lethal damage, it will actually grant us a half soul heart if we take lethal damage, which is good. Or because we're gonna need it. Now, there was a couple of tricks that you could do in Vanilla Isaac, which I have since forgotten, but where you could essentially get unlimited payouts from, like, say, a blood bank, where if you walk out of the room and come back in and Scapular has not procced yet, Scapular is that yellow aura that we have around Isaac's head, by the way, that would allow you to have technically unlimited HP, so you can get whatever you need from a blood bank. Man, words cannot begin to describe how much I would love a bomb, a pill, a reroll. I mean, this is gonna be rough. Not Ragman. Okay, it's Widow. Not Champion Widow. This is still not great because Widow does spawn a lot of ads here. How does this rate on the scale of 1 to 10? 10 being the absolute worst start in history versus 1 being like just it's a mild inconvenience. This start is I would say it's a 9. It's not the worst start we've ever had. The only way that this start could have gotten ever, like, even worse is if we had a completely useless passive item that we started with. Like, you know, something that wasn't helping us immediately, which right now this is not helping us immediately, but I mean it's not like we had Spider Babby or, you know, something like that. At least Mom's Contact can help us if we do get piercing shots or a better tears rate or really anything. every ad that Widow spawns adds like a 5 minute total to this run. Alright. Just out of the one fryer into the frying pan. I see, I got you, Isaac. Alright. These spiders, man, they, I swear, they've been taking extra little steps here and there. And have been moving in a very strange way lately. Damage, I'll take it. I can't complain about that. Pentagram, one of the best items we could have hoped for right now. Curse of Darkness. But hey, it's not a Curse of the Blind. Is Pentagram better than us getting Red Heart HP? Yes. Is it better than getting a Tears upgrade? Absolutely not. but Pentagram will at least lessen the blow a little bit anyway of how long it takes us to clear rooms. And I remember, the faster we can clear rooms, the safer we can be. That's extremely important. Now, the all-important question is, are we going to get HP? Or, just screw HP, are we going to get a key to get into the item room? Because right now, we haven't had any drops. The only pennies that we've gotten were already on the ground. So, like, you know, if you want to toss me a little help here, thank you, game. That's a start. Now, I know that there is a... Excuse me. There's a stone chest here. One thing I don't know, though, is if one bomb is going to be able to reach that, so... And to be quite honest, this bomb that we have is way more valuable than taking a chance on a chest that we may not get access to. Thank you. Thank you, flies, for doing me the favor here. Would I buy red candle or blue candle if I had a chance? Absolutely, dude. So this High Priestess card is very, very important because this will allow us to basically insta-dunk the boss. And that brings up a whole new world of possibilities for us because we don't have to worry about taking a lot of damage, if any, on the boss, especially if it's someone like, really anyone. The only, the only boss that we wouldn't be able to one-shot immediately would be if it was double champion Monstro. Since we're on the cellar, it can be Monstro, it can be... it can't be pinned, but who else is on there? I think, is Ragman part of the basement or the cellar? I always forget that now. Either way, we don't have to worry about the boss as long as we don't use it accidentally. We do still need a key. Well, here's the boss. Now, as much as I would love to go fight the boss right now, we can't. Not safely, and even if we were somehow able... we're going to be able to beat the boss. That's not a problem. The problem is taking the deal with the devil. If we don't get a red heart from the boss, there is no way that we can take a deal with the devil safely. And that is a huge pickup right there. Okay, so the golden key gives us a lot of hope. This room, however, does not. This room is actually the worst thing in the world. And again, given the circumstances that what exactly hit that bomb? Or hit that, was that one of the mom's, like, backward shots? That looked like the Isaac torso shot the barrel. I'm actually, like, astounded that happened. We need to get this burning... There we go. It's funny, game. It's real funny. You put me on a burning basement with Curse of Darkness and Smokey, and you knowingly put barrels there that you know I'm going to hit with a backward shot. That's cute. Sad bombs. We need there to be a soul heart in this shop. Which there is. There's more than that. There is also... Yes, I am aware that there is a demon fire here. So, I don't know about you, but, like, I'm 100% okay with taking, like, all the money we can out of this donation machine. Now, I'm not going to use every single bomb. Do we want Nun's Habit? Possibly. Nun's Habit is not exactly what I would say is the best item for us. We could also be super risky and go for, go for the Omega Penny or Dad's Penny or whatever. Man, this is just awful. I'll get another one of these rooms, I guess. No, you stay back there. I think I may upgrade this to a 10. As far as the worst possible start. It's, like, it's 10 minutes, and we're on floor 2. We have not fought the boss yet. There's a tendon rock in here, by the way. In case if you thought I didn't see it. Okay. All I'm asking for is a little help here. It gives us tears up. The reason why I don't sound as excited, though, is obviously, hopefully for obvious reasons, that the movement speed down is a big-time problem. Do we want to buy this pill? What would be the worst possible pill? Bad trip, probably. Yeah, we can't... can you get a... I always forget. Can you get bad trip if you've... If you're on Soul Hearts? I don't remember. I mean, well, we can ask, I guess. You know what? I completely forgot about that stone chest. Hang on. By the way, just sit back and relax, because we've got ourselves a whole long way to go if we don't die. I'm almost guaranteeing that this doesn't hit this chest, but I'm going to try anyway. Yeah. There was a bomb. I think there's a bomb still in the store. Trust me, I'm not as happy about this. I'm just as unhappy about this run as you are. But, I mean, you got to give me a little bit of a break here if you're seeing what the game has given me so far. I'd sure like to know how another Isaac player could have done what we've done so far, outside of not shoot that barrel. Which I didn't see. I swear to God, I didn't see that barrel there. It gave us our bomb back. Did we look for the super secret room? Where would it even be? It would have to be... It's not there, obviously. It could either be left of this room. Down or left of this room. Yeah, we don't have enough. You could argue that I should have saved those bombs to check for it. I would argue that there's no guarantee that even if we did get something in the super secret room, it wouldn't have helped us. He dodged the foot. I am so mad right now. What is that, Tyrone? The foot landed on him, but apparently it didn't. Oh. Don't ever say that Invicta's got good luck in Isaac. All those runs that I get carried on every now and then where the game's like, yeah, don't worry, I got you, bro. Yeah, that you can take that and you can go on a long walk with a short cliff. Look, it doesn't matter right now. I'm so seethingly angry that we didn't hit that Monstro with the priestess card. That's ridiculous, game. Oh, you killed the champion! Oh, that's great. Ugh. We're not going to be able to take a double D, are we? Nope. Wow. This is... Yeah, this is a 10. Definitely a 10 on the terrible start meter. I mean, and you got to remember too, the only upgrades that we've gotten, we almost died for. Like, I'm super glad that we got Small Rock, and I'm really, really happy that we got Pentagram. But, good God, man. I mean, I don't know what I have to do to get a semi-decent start in a run these days. It seems like we hit 100 and all of a sudden the game is like, oh yeah, it was... Remember all those good vibes you were feeling? Uh-uh. And I'm sorry if this commentary is stressing you out. It's stressing me out. This run feels like it's tainted. Like, it feels like there's forces working against us that I cannot control right now. And the last time we got that, we had that feeling, we almost died. We almost died on this run multiple times, actually. Already. It's freaking 14 minutes and we're on Catacombs 1. Would I still re-roll? Yeah. Where do I sign for that, please? Let me know where I can re-up for the re-roll. This needs to not be greed. I cannot explain to you how much I need you to not be a greed fight. what a fantastic... See, the problem is that that's not the... This is not the jar of flies. This is the jar that contains hearts. Because I'm pretty sure that they changed that graphic now. Yeah, save your life. Is it better than Butterbean? I never thought that I would have to make that argument, but I would say no, it's not. If we had red heart containers, then absolutely. But Butterbean actually, as dumb as this sounds, it does give us a little bit of protection. Trust me, I feel as dirty as you are hearing that. I feel just as dirty saying it. But Butterbean actually does give us a little bit of protection. If something is too close, we can hopefully knock them away far enough to where we can create an opening for ourselves to get away. This is just... I implore you, watch this run on 2.5 speed, because I'm already seeing an hour and a half run time on this run. Unless something major happens, or we die, of course. Dying is a very, very real possibility. We could actually lose the streak here. And honestly, I would not be surprised, because this run is awful. Again, another awful run. Will the game bail us out? I have no earthly idea. I hope so, but at this point, it doesn't feel like the game's even trying. Let's take stock of everything that we have that's going on for us. We've got good damage for where we are. We've got a fantastic bomb synergy here with sad bombs. If I ever run into a room like this, I can just do that and relatively stay safe, for the most part anyway. Until the Skitterer gets out and starts freaking out and moving at 10,000 miles an hour times light speed. And the spawning nubs that will spawn other spiders because, you know, we gotta have the hard counter to our no tears having ways. But then we can safely get out of this room. Sad bombs is a big get for us. Not only did it give us 5 bombs, but it does give us a little bit more of a safety net if we have to drop it. Obviously, I would prefer not to... I'm fighting the temptation to use a sad bomb every single room we go into. But we just... I have to conserve. I have to use them for bosses. Unless we get a Chaos card or a High Priestess card, which I would have thought was a blessing. But apparently Monstro is wearing his big boy pants today. Yeah, that's 100% my fault because I'm too busy trying to be smart and not dodging. I have to. I don't want to, but I have to. Okay, we got a bomb back, which I'm going to lay down for Chubb. And by Chubb, I mean Grub. And completely miss it. And, yeah. There's no way I was going to fight Grub. So, we didn't really gain anything for this room. But, man, if that would have been, like, I don't know, Fate or Eternal Heart or, you know, Cricket's Head or Guppy's Paw, or really anything, it would have been an amazing play. That would have looked cool doing it, too, but instead we've got a 6 tier delay with a 0.81 move speed. okay, alright. I forgot, we move like we have 30-pound elephant foot toenails tied to our freaking shoelaces right now. We're not even wearing shoes. Okay. We're starting to tilt a little bit. I mean, can you blame me, though? Like, can you really blame me? I'm telling you, man, this run just feels like the game is working for a victory. For itself, not us. I really don't want to go into a big room. We're looking for the item room. There's a tinted rock here, which I am very... Just looking for the item room. Just give me the item room. Give me the item room and let it be the D4 for the love of crap. Yeah, this is a 10. This is in terms of worst possible runs imaginable by this stage. I mean, look at this. This is just a clown show. We don't even have the shot speed to keep up with the floor lickers. Our shots have to like say, "Oh, of course there's going to be a dead end." All right. Well, a penny. One penny. I'm not feeling it. Just not feeling it. I'm feeling the loss on this run. I'm trying to stay positive. It's been a bad week. Terrible weekend. Trying to look at things on the upside right now just to change the mood, and man, the only upside is that I guess we haven't died yet. If that's your only upside for this run, then you've got some problems on your hand there, bud. Because, man. Enjoy this game. You enjoy this run. Because when the reckoning comes at you, it's going to be right in the face, if you know what I mean. Because you ain't getting up from that nap anytime soon after I'm done with you. Alright, what's behind door number 3? It's a freaking guardian fly. Oh. It's 21 minutes in this catacombs one. I have no words for this run. I'm sorry. I have no words that can describe. It's just one big, huge, disappointing outing after another from this run. Now, the saving grace in this room is the red poops. Are the red poops, I should say. Really wish he'd stop spawning stuff. Yeah, but like, if you could just stop spawning stuff, I'd appreciate it. Alright, so we're gonna use the red poop to our advantage here. And I'm just not even gonna bother trying to keep up with Stain while he's firing. We still got hit. I can't say anything anymore. Just punch me out, game. Just punch me out, I'm done. No deal with the devil and a red HP upgrade. Might be the worst run ever. I'm really trying to think hard about what we deemed the worst run ever last time, and if it was worse than this. I don't think it's possible. This is in the running. It's been a very long time since we've seen a 23-minute Catacombs 2 run. No deal with the devil. No deal with the angel. No random soul hearts from tinted rocks. We just get golden chests that give us nothing. No eternal hearts. No trinkets. No cards. Oh, that's a funny game. It's real funny. I mean, stop me when we get to the good part. We have to take the nubs out here first. All they're going to do is act as blocks for us not to be able to walk by trying to kite the fatty baddies. Or they could do, like, the most awesome split of all time. We have... I mean, again, I'm trying to think of the positives here. It's not even our damage anymore. Our damage is going to quickly start falling off here. All right, we got one. Woo, we got one. Yeah, we killed a fatty baddie. How long will it take us to kill the other one, Jim? Well, I'm guessing another 10 shots because, you know, we have the shot speed of a dead sloth. Well, that's funny, game. That's real funny. Enjoy it. Yeah, freaking data miner. Yep, no bombs. Might be the worst ever. Might be the worst ever. I see no redeeming qualities in this run at all. The only redeeming quality, if by some miracle of all the Jesuses known to Earth, we win this run, that's the only positive, is that you can say I was able to beat this giant flaming trash fire dumpster turd of a run. Now, yes, I could use Data Miner and access that golden chest. Trust me, I'm aware of that. But the problem is that we don't have anything that doesn't help us. That doesn't help us with the tinted rock. My concern is not the golden chest, because we need to go into the store here, assuming we don't die to these chub vises or vies or vs, whatever the heck they're called. All right, got another one down. Here we go. Just carving through the ranks. Carving through the ranks, Isaac. See, these are the type of runs that people subscribe to me to only because they love to see me lose for some reason. I would hope that my regular fans love to see me win, and they hate to see me. Oh, that's just fan. They hate to see me be at the game's terrible RNG mercy like this. But there's at least one guy out there who is just tickled pink. And he's probably got a tickled pink shirt on, saying, "Yes, finally! Sticking it to Sinvicta." Tarot cloth. What are we gonna get? A hermit card. Hooray. I mean, what do you do here? Do you buy a key? I think you have to. Well, I honestly, first off, yes, I was looking for a bomb, so I wouldn't have to do this. And secondly, I don't know if we use Data Miner, if that's going to give us access to that golden chest. I just don't know. I don't think it will. It did. Just I'm not gonna roll over and die. I'm not rolling over on this run. But at this point, You gotta say it's the worst run you've ever seen. I don't remember what we deemed the worst run last time. I know it was during the streak, and we ended up winning that, obviously. But this one is just... It's 30 minutes, and we're in Catacombs 2. It's not even like I'm trying to take my time here. No bomb. Just kill me. Just gun to my head. Just end this run. No. Sinvicta doesn't give up. He ain't no punk. He ain't no punk, B. I'm sorry. I don't know what else I can say right now. There's nothing, no sort of insightful stream of consciousness commentary that I can offer right now. There's none. I'm out of. That's all I can say. That's my commentary right there. All right, yeah, just another red heart. Oh, God forbid we get a bomb or something that could actually help us. Just one bomb. Just a bomb. One bomb and give us two soul hearts out of the tinted rock, please. Wow, that was like the most amazing juke. Yeah, this is I'm officially calling it. This is the worst run I've ever seen. I have never seen a run this bad. I bet I have time to look up. I bet I have time to look up what we deemed as the worst run ever, and it's not going to affect the runtime of this video at all. Let's see. Worst run ever. What did we have for the worst run ever? It was episode 186. That was February 20th of this year. Didn't we end up getting Magic Mush on this run? We started with 2.95 damage, 1.01 movement speed. Hey, that sounds pretty familiar. We had more range, and we had more shot speed. Where were we by the 30 minute 26 second mark? I don't even know where we were. Yeah, we were already in Necropolis by this point in that run. And we got Black Candle as well, and 9 lives by that time. We have a new champion. Congrats, everyone. We've made it. We have made it. This is officially the worst Isaac run I have ever seen. Here we are. Rocky like a freaking hurricane. Yeah, that run, give me that other run that I just looked at 100 times out of 100 times versus this run. We had 9 lives. We had Black Candle by this point in that run. Excuse me? When did this turn into wait? It's not Butterbean. I don't know what's going on anymore. Does Butterbean have an effect if you use it enough times it turns into wait what? Or did they change? I don't even know at this point. All I know is we got a bomb. I'm gonna go back to this tinted rock. By the way, to those of you who took my heeded my earlier advice about turning this on 2.5 speed, I'm happy for you. I'm glad that you listened, because man, I wish I could do the same right now. A soul heart. And a High Priestess card. Thank goodness. This allows us to get past this next floor. Or this floor, rather. I bet there's probably some people watching this, and they're just awestruck with how bad it is. I'm awestruck with how bad it is. It takes a lot for me to say that something is the worst of all time. I mean, you know, I complain when things aren't going my way. I think everyone knows that. And I recognize that. I understand. Again, I'm fine with it. It's a character flaw. It's a character flaw. However, it takes a lot for me to say that this is the worst of all time. We can't take Circle of Peace. Relic, I love you. I'm glad that you're with us. Thank you very much. Can Butterbean break? It can. And there's an Eternal Heart. Oh, it's like a breath of fresh air. There are so many people right now who... again, I didn't know... Apparently Butterbean turns into Wait What? If I had known that, I would have been using that against the... or not against, but I would have been using that for the Timid Rock. That's a functionality of an item that I have never known about. Obviously, because I would have used it by now. The Eternal Heart gives me hope. We get free entry in here, and this counts as a clear room for the relic. Do I want to use the Hermit card to save this half heart? I'm actually going to. As dumb as that might seem, I think we have to. Apparently it does not affect the Keeper. It's alright. So now that I know that we have Wait What, it's not Butterbean. That gives us a little bit more hope. Because we don't have to use bombs for anything but offense now. And we can break into anything that we need as far as secret rooms are concerned. So that's good. Very good. Is this still the worst run I've ever seen? Yeah. It's bad. It's real bad. While we're waiting for this one to look up, I'm actually going to look up Butterbean. Because I'm very curious to see what Aluk says about this. Happy birthday, Aluk, by the way. Butterbean. Unlock. Alright. Where's Wait What? Wait. What? Upon use this item, fart, pushing away enemies. No. I have to be missing something, because Butterbean, we had Butterbean. I've used the knockback before, unless I'm completely blind and wasn't paying attention. I know for a fact that we had Butterbean to start with this. Yeah, because we've used it to deflect things, and it certainly didn't do the shockwave of Wait What. I'm not going crazy here. I mean, I might be going crazy at this point. I don't freaking know, dude. I don't know. At this point, I just don't know. All I know is that I want a lot of damage and a lot of tears rate at this point. I should, you know, since I know we have Wait What, I should be waiting until it charges before going to the next room. Oh yeah, it does not affect flying enemies. Good to know. Relic should be paying out here after this room. Was holding on to that black half black heart worth it? Probably, because if we do get hit, at least we can clear a room with it. It's more damage than we're going to be doing. Relic did not pay out. Did it pay out? Oh, it must have paid out in the curse room. And again, my memory at this point is just gone. It's just a blank. Secret room is not going to be to the right of there. Yeah. It didn't even kill him. Didn't even hurt him. They're just smiling and asking for another at this point. Thank you, Relic. Thank you. The virus might actually be huge for us here. If Lust drops the virus. The virus could give us a little ray of sunshine hope. I can't take a pill at this point. I can't risk the health down. Wouldn't be terrible, but it would be bad. the worst thing would be tears down at this point. We can't lose any stat. Well, thank you, creep statue. I appreciate that. Finally, something... Oh, you know what? There must be a greed fight in there. I was going to say, oh, no, there can't be, because we just fought lost. Never mind. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Ipecac statue. I see you. Yeah, that is an absolute no-take. If we took Shielded Tears on a run that has this low of shot speed and this low of tears rate, we would not kill anything that has projectiles. There is no way that I can take that. The only circumstance that I would take that is if we had the D4 or the D100. Okay, so we can get free access into our item room, assuming we don't die in this room. The revenge fly is actually helping out, but you're seeing the reason why it would have been so nice to have the virus. Oh yeah, you're not a chub vis, you're a brimstone vis. That's inexcusable damage right there. You're doing God's work, revenge fly. There's no excuse to use a key here. Since we can just go in there with, wait, what? I love you, Odd Mushroom. Thank you for being here. You gave us speed down, but you know what? I'll take it anyway. Pandora's Box. Now, Pandora's Box on Depths 1 is, I want to say that it is a boss item. I'm sorry about all the alt tabbing, by the way. Please feel free to dislike this video. Yeah, Depths 1, 4 soul hearts. Depths 2 is 20 coins. I was thinking of Womb 1. Yeah, we're going to use that now. And I guess we're just going to re-roll here, even though we don't have a whole lot of money. Nightlight, no thank you. Part of me really wants to just go get those full charges, but part of me would also be mad at myself for doing so. Okay. Please be a Joker card. It's a Joker card. Holla freaking Luya. Okay. We're building something here. And for the record, no, I'm not saying that we're okay now. We're not. We are far from okay. Pandora's Box helping us here is an absolute huge big time play. That's the kind of plays that we look for. We preach about it all the time in the locker room, in the practice field. We want to see people out there hustling. If you want to get put in the game, you gotta hustle as fast as you can. But we need something more than just little rays of sunshine here and there. I am waiting for wait what before we go into this next room, because I don't know what's in there. Would have sworn it would have been there. Although now, upon further reflection, it wouldn't have been there. It's going to be either above that room. It's not going to be to the left. Now that I've come near. I mean, again, Fat on Mushroom, it's a damage up. It gives us an empty heart container. It's huge. If we're going to be slower than dirt, we might as well at least be able to hit hard. Which is why I had no problem taking a Fat on Mushroom. I really want to take pills. I really, really do. Oh, we can't get out of here like that. Right, we had to take the Brimstone Spider first. Then the creepy crawler is not too bad. All right. Are we better than we were 20 minutes ago? I mean, how can you even ask that question? Of course we are. You know, is this a one run? Absolutely not. What run are you watching? No. No, 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 no. Far from it. Far from one run, my friend. But I appreciate you being here. Hopefully, this run hasn't turned you off to the entire Isaac series. We actually do have good runs every now and then. I am a semi-decent player at Isaac sometimes when I'm not getting completely screwed by the game or, you know, making bad plays or not knowing what items do. Other than that, yeah, I'm a good Isaac player. Welcome. My new subscribers are like, is every Isaac video like this? No, please. Please do not, don't misconstrue the Eden Streak and the Isaac series on the in general. Don't judge it by this run. You're doing yourself and the other runs a disservice by doing that. Please don't. We have occasionally great runs. This is the worst. It's not the worst anymore, but it's pretty bad. Lucky rock that's going to give us coins every time that we break rocks. It's very, very useful. Yeah, I think we just go in. And it would have to be Gish, wouldn't it? He just had to give us a boss that you know that we couldn't possibly get a stat upgrade from, game, didn't you? Couldn't have been, like, you know, Bloat. Couldn't have been Adversary. Couldn't have been Dark One. It had to be Gish, huh? Little Gish, you're about the most underwhelming item that I could have ever not hoped for right now. Now, here's the real kicker. Imagine if we don't get a deal with the devil. We use our Joker card, and there's Krampus in there. Wouldn't that be neat? And then we get another kicker for you. What do we take? Do we keep... Wait, what? Or do we go for Krampus's head? I'm going to be 100% honest. I think we stick with wait, what? If it's Krampus in there, having the ability to break every rock without worrying about using bombs and making money for it because of the lucky rock, yeah, I think that sticking with wait, what is an absolutely correct answer for that. I mean, yeah, Krampus's head is a boss killer for sure, but we can kill bosses right now. I don't have to worry too much about losing HP here and there. I mean, it's not optimal, obviously. All right, let's see if this Invicta prophecy comes true. Dead Sea. Now you might be asking, where on earth are you going, nerd? Just go to the next floor. I have to go into the curse room. I didn't want to do this. Not curse room, but boss trap, mob trap room. We need to see what's inside that cursed chest. If it's the pact, if it's 9 lives, is it anything worthwhile? Or it could just be spiders. Or troll bombs, hooray. Now, all kidding aside, Lil Gish does help us out a little bit. No pun intended there. If anything, it allows us to get a little bit more DPS out per shot. And if the Gish slowing effect actually kicks in, that's really good. That helps us catch up in meaningful ways on our target. I don't know why I'm doing this stupidly. It's like, ooh, these guys are on the ground, man. I shouldn't use our giant earthquake attack. A key. Man, oh man. The problem here is that it's only going to get worse. It can only get worse from here, because we have to go to depths 2 and then it's off to the womb. I mean, you all know how Isaac's played at this point. Don't know what I was expecting to find in here. Don't think it was going to be Blast Assist, though. But he might drop something cool for us. That'd be neat. I mean, sure. Man. This... I'm stupefied. It's like seeing a car wreck. I can't believe... My eyes can't process what I'm seeing right now. For the love of everything, please be something we can use. Or just be a 3 Skull Monty. Hey, we got our bombs back at least. Alright, Depths 2, how you doing? Hello, Depths 2! Yep, alright, cool. Neat. You know what, I'm just gonna wait. Let's see what the latest fashions are here. Yeah, like I kinda like that. Matchbook looking pretty good for you, Isaac. Don't know about the hair, though, but you got the whole husky hair going on right now. If you don't know what I'm talking about, by the way, husky dyed his... He bleach blonded his hair. Well, that was a while ago, but I'm pretty sure it's still like that. And he's got like a whole comb over hipster thing going on. I made fun of him. Trust me. I don't worry. I did you a favor, world. I made fun of Husky just for that. I was like, man, that lawnmower just won a whole lot of money off of you in that fight. And he was like, oh, look at me, I'm Sinvicta. That's the extent of our conversations. Husky's one of my best friends. And we just talk in insults. But that one person who knows that Husky has a haircut like our Eden does right now is just laughing. Hey, you know what? I'm glad. Please find something to laugh about. Because this run is no laughing matter. Dun, dun, dun. I think I could have recited half of the Jurassic Park script by now. And still have gotten as far as we are in this run. We're at critical levels of... We need a game changer here. Either in the way of... In the form of reroll or hard carry item. We are in dire need because the HP that we have will not last long in the womb. At all. The relic is going to help us out greatly. But that's only a band-aid for a gushing wound if we don't find some damage soon. Or a tears up. Or movement speed up. Or flying. Or just anything. This is a make or break run. This is seriously a make or break floor for this run. We have to get a deal with the devil here. And it has to be a good item. It has to be Maw of the Void, Brimstone, Mom's Knife, Abaddon. I mean, pick your poison. We can't go wrong. Satanic Bible would be a great help. What kind of flies are these? These are hush flies. Why are hush flies here? Two of diamonds. Very happy to have that. We haven't gotten a greed fight yet, though, so this tells me that we're due. And that two of diamonds card pretty much solidifies that we are going to have a greed fight in the shop. Revenge fly is a big get as well. That's going to help us out greatly. We have been saved. The D100. How unbelievable. Oh, D100, we owe you whatever kind of drink you want, bro. You got it. It's drinks are on me tonight. You talk about bailout. You talk about big time plays. D100 coming up. Making the big time plays, hustling, putting all that stuff that we put into practice out every day in, day out on the field. Doing his homework, studying the playbook. That's what I like to see, son. That's what I like to see. We got the D100. And there's a greed fight in here, which means that our shop is actually going to be a shop. This is unbelievable. There is someone who just hates my guts right now because they really love to see me lose. And they are ruin the day that D100 ever got added to the game. You know what, angry nerd? I'm glad that your day has been ruined now because my day just got a whole lot better. That is, you talk about miracle. You talk about... needing a Hail Mary. I said it on this floor. I said this has to be our make or break floor for us. Something drastic has to happen or we are going to lose this. I firmly believe that we would have lost this run. Oh man, welcome everybody. Welcome to the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. My name is Invicta here on a 102 Eden streak. If you look to our left, you'll see a very happy nerd. If you look to our right, you'll see a very unhappy nerd because they were hoping that I was going to die. And they're very upset that I got the D100 and bailed out on a terrible, god-awful, just garbo run. I can see forever. Sure. Sounds good, Isaac. What we got? Beelzebub. We got flying. No problem. We got bomb bag here. I don't even know what that is behind us. Who is that? I don't know what baby that is, but we have Hive Mind. I don't know why laid a bomb there. Also, oh, we have restock. And the mind as well, I think. What baby is that? Now, this damage is awful. Don't get me wrong. Our damage is 3.04, but who cares? We have the D100, and we also have Mom's Knife. So we also have restock, which means that we can... Theoretically, we can go through a lot of stuff in the shop before re-rolling. Assuming there's a full charge in there. Oh, this damage is just terrible. I mean, this is abysmal damage here. But it doesn't matter, because we got the D100. We can just re-roll! Whee! Oh, man, this is the greatest run ever. What a fantastically disingenuous statement to make. I don't remember what life is like before we had... Look, like, what is this? You know what? Not even gonna mess with it, dude. I don't remember what life is like without having 16 tiers. Thank you, Wire Code Hanger. Mr. Mega, good to see ya. Seeing all the big-time players come out today. No, I don't really want missing page number 2. Seraphim, did we get Chaos? Is that the reason why we're seeing these angel items in here? We must have gotten Chaos at some point. Guardian Angel. Euthanasia. I mean, all this is moot anyway, because we're going to re-roll, but I'm just looking. A little Delirium. Synth Oil. Skinny on Mushroom. Yes, I will hold that. Our damage is still 3.04, and we still have 16 tiers rate.
Joker.
And if you can believe it, we've gotten even slower. Yep, we have gotten even slower. Fungi transformation, I like it. Our damage is even worse now. Mama Mega gets us into boss rush. We have the Holy Mantle. Is there a reason why our movement speed is still this bad? I wonder. No, this is what we need to do. We need to put the D100 down, and then we need to use Diplopia. Then we need to pick up the other D100, and then roll that one. Now we're talking. Oh God, we've got Epic Fetus, Proptosis, Dogtooth. It doesn't matter. This is what we're sticking with. Now the funny thing is, we can still get into the boss rush. If you would have told me 50 minutes ago that this run would have gotten into the boss rush, I would have said, "What are you smoking?" And don't give any, because I don't smoke, but I don't want any. But if I did smoke, I would definitely want some, because that's crazy talk. Now, the only bad thing about this is that if we go into boss rush and we get a deal with the devil, it's possible that we may not be able to get into the deal with the devil room. So we have to ask ourselves... No, wait. We've already been to the deal with the devil room. Never mind. Yeah, because we got Eucharist. That's right. Then we rolled it. Our tier delay is 52. I don't know what's exploding. I'm not even shooting. There we go. You know what I should do? I should just be staying in front of the fire. That works too. Butt bombs. Butt bombs doing it big for us. What we got here? Juice's freaking shadow. We need to turn into Black Judas. Because Black Judas carries over, regardless of us. As long as we turn into Black Judas before we reroll next time, we will stay as Black Judas. So, what we're going to do is we're going to go in here, and we're gonna stay alive until we have a full charge on the D100, and then we're going to deuce on out. Because we need to turn into Black Judas. Although, if we had a way, well, maybe we don't have to get out of here, because, I mean, we're doing an incredible amount of damage. The problem is that we don't have explosion immunity, and that's an issue because of the fact that we've got so huge bombs. Bobby bombs is also going to be a little bit problematic because we don't have the movement speed capable enough for us to get away from our target that we don't get hit by our own explosion. But this is sort of like carpet bomb AoE nuking from like the corner, and that's pretty good. I don't know, we might just hold on to Black Judas and stick with this run. Oh god. That was almost like morbid. Even for Isaac's sake. Oh, Steven. Just didn't even see it coming. Oh, it's Ragman. Hello. Goodbye. Yeah, this is pretty good. We're doing an impressive amount of damage with butt bombs here. If only we had it. If we had explosion immunity, this would be the perfect run. But I'm willing to give this one a shot for now. If we start to get in trouble, then once our HP gets low, or we find like something good, you know, I may reroll. But I think actually giving up this synergy right now is not a good idea. I think Black Judas is a good insurance policy for this run. And again, MVP goes straight up to the D100. I think I should... Oh, we have minus touch too, apparently. I think I should get a little credit for surviving the early parts of this run. Because we were in some gnarly situations, but let's not mince words here. The D100 is king here. It's an hour and 2 minutes into this video, and we're only now getting to Utero. That's just horrifying, Isaac. Yeah, that works. Is it me or does Big Chub look even bigger than usual? He must have BFF or something. I don't even ask me what I'm going to be able to do in this room. All right, never mind. The guillotine, normally I'd be bummed out about that. I'm not. Our run could not have gotten any worse before this, so I am happy with what we've got, man. Not sure how that happened. Alright. Well, is getting a devil deal that important? Honestly, no, not at this point. Especially if we have gotten... Chaos. Which I'm pretty sure that Chaos does not transfer through character rerolls, so... Whatever you do, do not drop a troll bomb. I will let that bomb explode and kill you and laugh about it. Austin is telling me that there's something here. No, it's got to be there. Yeah. There's a full charge there. I appreciate that. I just now realized that we are not going in the right direction. Alright, Demon Judgment, I like where your head's at. I'm not going to utilize you currently, as I am indisposed of at the moment, mentally. How do I know this is not the right way to go? Because there's a loop over there, and very rarely will the boss ever be on a loop. Very, very rarely. Now, we've got knockout power with these Dr. Fetus bombs here. That's tempting. Very tempting. I think we need to go see if we can get a devil deal first before trying that. If we can get a devil deal here, that would be awesome. Because that would give me something to consider about turning into Black Judas or not. And I think that... It's not this way. Where would the boss room be? You know what? It's an XL floor, so it is possible it could have been on that loop, but I think it's actually to the upper right. All right, you know what? I don't feel like coming back here. Don't know what I was expecting there. Do not want addicted. To be honest, I shouldn't even like try to even care about the devil deal at this point. It's not important. The only thing that's important is that we keep Juice's shadow and we turn into black. If we are going to reroll, we need to turn into black Juice before rerolling. That's the only thing that matters. Everything else just doesn't matter. So I can play a little bit faster and looser than I normally would here in this circumstance, because I'm not worried about the deal with the devil. If we get one, great, but if not, it's honestly not that big of a deal. Man, I do not remember life. Let's try this again, shall we? I don't remember life back before we had good movement speed. What was it like in the olden times? Oh, Triacnid got his lunch eaten right there. I mean, that's just solid damage. That's just beautiful damage. And it's a Krampus fight. Of course it is. Alright. Alright. Lumbicol. Yep. Let's just go up. Wow, only 4 minutes to get through the womb. What kind of run is this? Why
you taking too long, Victor? What kind of terrible Isaac player are you?
I don't know, the bad kind, I guess. How do you want me to answer that? Zodiac is interesting. I really want to turn into Black Judas on this floor. But is that wise? Do we need to turn into Black Juice at all? I want to keep rerolling because I dislike this movement speed, and I also really hate the guillotine.
Or the guillotine.
But it's hard to argue with his damage. I mean, his damage is phenomenal. You feeling okay there, Daddy? I could have swore I saw two of you there. That's good. No, you can have that penny. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that we don't need to turn into Black Judas to win this run. Assuming that I stay with this, of course. Right now I'm just looking for an excuse to turn into Black Judas. If I see even one soul heart on the ground, that's enough for me. This is going to be a slam dunk. Don't even try, Isaac. Oh, D100, I love you. You know what? Whatever. Let's just go. I have been sitting in this chair long enough to where I've become one with the chair. I need to get up and stretch my back. I'm not feeling the greatest. Well, if we do find HP, I know which room I'm going to be rerolling in. This damage is so good. That is some chunky damage right there. Where are we going, Isaac? Not the right way. Got it.
Should be looking at the map soon, Victor.
Look, I'm still, like, elated that we're even in this position, okay? After the 50 minutes of hell that we were put through on this run, let me enjoy myself, alright? Just get off my back. Besides, you're watching this at least 1.5 speed anyway, so what do you care? Alright, we need to start thinking about possibly turning into Black Judas. I mean, turning into Black Judas is fine. The only thing that I'm worried about doing that is if we roll into something terrible, and we don't have a lifeline of an extra life. That's the only thing that's keeping me from really even, like, caring about this. If I'll say this, if we get to black, if we get to Blue Baby, and we're not Black Judas, I'm just gonna go with what we've got, because we can kill Blue Baby with this. And I mean, anything to get me out of this run is a win in my book. Please. Yeah, not really what I want, Judgment. Spilt milk might actually be okay. Spilt milk will give us a huge tears up if we get hit. Yeah, I say we just do it. Let's just do it. We can beat Blue Baby with this easily. Oh yeah. And then yes, I'll re-roll after we're done with Blue Baby just to see what we would have gotten. Alright. Alright, just can't let me have my fun. What would we have gotten? Spun? Just terrible. Yeah, I'm glad we didn't re-roll. Well, thank you for watching, everyone. Happy Sunday. Hope you enjoyed that run. I really, really hope that you put it on times 2 speed. If you didn't, what the heck's wrong with you? And subscribe if you want to see more of my channel. And ring the notification bell, although rumor has it that may not even work anymore. So, hey, you know what? YouTube. That's all I gotta say. YouTube, LOL. Just like this freaking run. Just get off my monitor.